Hello everyone, and welcome to another psychic investigation video. So this time around I will be checking a concept of name numerology. So this is a rather, I guess, easy subject for me to cover, but before I go into detail I will read some description. So get ready. A brief introduction to numerology. Numerology is a system of divination based on the belief that each of the natural numbers 1, 2, 3, etc. represents a different quality in nature or human experience. Finding the specific number that applies to an event or person therefore allows us to determine the fundamental essence of the situation or individual. The origins of numerology can be traced back to classical Greece and particularly to the philosopher Pythagoras. He lived from 570 to 495 before Christ. The Pythagorean school saw numbers as the foundation of all things and as having mystical properties. In its simplest form, numerology is the basis for the distinction between traditionally lucky and unlucky numbers, for example, 7 and 13. The most widely used numerology systems are based on distinguishing between the qualities associated with the single digits. 0 is not considered a natural number in numerology and is generally ignored. So, we got the numbers from 1 to 9. And those are usually the ones being unanalyzed. So to determine the numerological significance of a number greater than 9, it is commonly reduced to its digital root. This is done by adding up all the digits in the number and repeating this addition until only one digit remains, a process known as philosophical addition. So, for example, the digital root of 417,063 is 3. This is because 4 plus 1 plus 7 plus 0 plus 6 plus 3 is 21. But 21 is also 2 plus 1, which is 3. So, the most elaborate forms of numerology, such as Hebrew gematria, use ideas associated with the full unreduced number. For example, the number 666 has traditional associations that give it a significance beyond that of its digital root, which is 9. Gematria and other related methods derive from ancient alphabets such as Greek or Hebrew, and which letters are also used to represent numbers. This means that it is possible to calculate a word's numerical value by considering each letter as a number and adding up the several values. So, gematria assumes that different words that sum to the same number are themselves meaningfully related. This allows us to gain insight into the deeper significance of the world by considering other words that have the same numerical value. So, our test is going to be simple. We will type down some names and we will see the reading for them. So, I guess here's the short description. Classical name numerology calculator. Click the buttons to spell your full name. This remains private and is not sent to our servers. Use the two-letter buttons where this appear in your name. So, basically this should work for any person. Doesn't matter who will come here. Same typed name will result in same result. Like for example, somebody will come and write down something like Sam. If I wrote down Sam and somebody else wrote down Sam, it will be the same result. So, as I guess a means to properly test this particular test, I guess in the numerology calculator, I will use some very specific names which I have prepared. So, I have searched for some evil people, and the idea is that if there's something wrong with a person, perhaps it might be reflected in this numerological calculator, because maybe there were some serious signs that a person would turn out evil just based on his particular name. So I guess time to check my first person. So I will begin with a short name form. It's Joseph Stalin. Stalin, I believe. I mean, my pronunciation is not perfect. Okay, Joseph. If you don't mind cooperating. My apologies. I have to click with letters. So J. Yes, O. S. E. I'm looking for P. Joseph. Okay, I found you. Okay, H. Oh, my apologies. I have to use PH because it is, I guess, available as an option. So never I can use P and H separately because whenever they are combined, I just have to use this particular option. So I will have to pay extra attention. Okay, so Joseph. Now we've got ourselves a space. And Stalin. Okay. So this is what we have. Okay, could I use any of these alternative words? Actually, alternative letters. Doesn't appear so. So we've got ourselves a name. So this is the current version. So this is what is explained to us. Practicality, orderliness, responsibility, planning, steadfastness, and work. And I wonder what inner will do. So I guess inner explanation would be variety, adventure, freedom, challenge, playfulness, restlessness, and curiosity. So I guess so far so good, and it does appear that okay, as far as I know, this particular person, I have not investigated his backstory very, very throughout. I guess I don't know every single aspect regarding him. But I do know some specific details of his life, some very, very specific details, like events, which usually are not covered in history, I guess, textbooks for students in schools. So, based on what I'm seeing, yes, planning. Steadfastness, work, orderliness. Okay. I believe it does somehow apply to Joseph Stalin, but. Okay, maybe freedom is potentially questionable. I guess the person himself was all about freedom. Playfulness. Now, that's something. I'm not in particular believing in, because particularly with Stalin, I believe there was a great, I guess, level of paranoia because he was afraid of being replaced. So it looks like this is not a very, very accurate test. And on top of that, what I'm seeing right here is that this was just some very few words and not many good explanations. So that's one thing. So I guess try to enter the full name of Joseph Stalin. So I checked the Wikipedia and hopefully I wrote it down correctly. So I have to type. I have to click actually. Okay, I need to use this typing method. Okay, these are. Actually, I can quickly verify. Joseph Stalin, and I guess a quicker confirmation. Yes, this one, Vizarionovich. Okay, so Vizarionovich. No. Okay, there's a letter N. Come to me. Vizarionovich. Which okay. Hopefully I didn't miss any of these special cases. It doesn't appear so. So I guess I will add the last I guess surname I believe. Okay, so stolen. Okay. Does anything change? So variety, adventure, freedom, challenge, playfulness, restlessness, curiosity. It appears to be the same. Oh, domesticity, companionship, love, nurture, care, comfort, service. Guy is paranoic, is has some paranoia, is maybe is capable of love, but not to his enemies, to put it lightly. I don't think he's a very caring person based on how many people in Russia died. Care? Nope. Comfort? Nope. So overall, I entered the full name given in Wikipedia, and apparently it's painting a kind of picture which is inaccurate. So okay, let's go to person number one, and he is. Let me type it down. Mao Zedong. All right, or Zedong actually. Mao Zedong. Okay, I usually don't pronounce names, so I might not be as good when it comes to these particular pronunciations. Okay, so Mao Zedong. Okay, contemplation, introversion, wisdom, mysticism, stoicism, spirituality, perfectionism. Some of these might apply, but if I remember correctly, Mao Zedong was not interested in spirituality, not really in mysticism. I mean, I, from my personal perspective, would not call him wise. Maybe he considered himself wise, but his decisions definitely were not of such. Maybe he was wise, I guess, in a sense that he got into power, but when it came to control of the nation, it was not really wise. Okay, so let's check the inner reading. Union, cooperation, stability, following, continuity, yin, receptivity, gentleness. So gentleness in particular, I don't believe that. Okay, so cooperation. I guess that one is right. I guess communist China was all about people, quote unquote, being forced to cooperate. I don't think it applied to Mao Zedong himself, but it applied to common Chinese people. Union. I'm not certain about that. Stability. I believe China had some economical problems, and Mao himself as a person, I guess he was stable, at least based on what I do know myself. So okay, this is my person number two. Now I'm going to go to my person number three. So I guess this is one person about whom I don't know too much background of his personal life, what kind of person he might be, but he's a rather famous individual. I guess he's already dead, but we are talking about J. Okay, where's that letter? Okay, Jeff. Jeff. Okay, where's the F? F. I need you, F. Oh, it was so close. Jeff. Okay, and where's the letter R? Jeffrey. Jeffrey. Okay, letter Y. Jeffrey Epstein. All right. Ep. And do I have something like ST? Nope. Okay, Jeffrey Epstein. So it's not the full name which I found on Wikipedia, but I guess maybe there'll be some information right here, right now. So we are dealing with somebody who is good at communication, interaction, expression, eloquence, intelligence, and versatility. Okay, might potentially. I will check the other interpretation. Domesticity, companionship, love, nurturance, care, comfort, and service. I don't believe this exactly apply because I mean, Jeffrey Epstein, he had a particular island which in which a lot of illegal activity was going on. And for this particular person, it should be some signs in his name, evaluation, that something might go wrong. And of course, I guess it's just another case. Just because you get a name, you might think, oh, there might be a big, big meaning to this. Perhaps because I have this name, I have this destiny. But so far, it looks like these names are really incapable of telling whether you are a bad person or not. And it appears that these names just tell a rosy picture for others. Then for the case, because I guess this is some sort of tool to inspire, but not a kind of tool to, I guess, be accurate. Because yes, it might make you feel good, it might make you feel like you can accomplish some things, but overall, it's just something made to make you feel good. It's my, I guess, perception right now, but I've still got some names to go through. And by the way, I will add the middle name too. Okay, let me do it. Edward. Okay, I think I'm getting more skilled with this typing tool. Okay, letter R. Edward. Edward. Epstein. Yet again. Yes, letter P. Letter P. Epstein. Alright, Epstein. Okay, did I type it right? It appears so. So we are dealing with compassion, philanthropy, generosity, idealism, magnanimity, completion, culmination. Sure, his life did culminate in not a very good fashion, but it did. Now, I guess we'll do a very quick translation. What in particular is magnanimity? Okay, I guess this series will teach me some better use of English words. Okay. The quality of being magnanimous, greatness of mind or heart, elevating of dignity of soul, the habit of feeling and acting worthily under all circumstances, high-mindedness, instinct, intrinsic nobility. I don't believe this applies at all. I mean, I'm probably very wrong because I don't think a noble, like a good-hearted person, would do something like have an island with a lot of bad behaviors being done in that area. So, name number two. I mean, if this does keep up, if these names do appear to be wrong, one after another, I probably will not even read this full list. Okay, so my next one. This one is really famous and not in particular liked by YouTube. So I won't mention his name loudly, but you should be able to see it. It has something to do with a dolphin. And I guess it has also something to do with hitting. So, letter A, letter D, okay, a few extra letters, I guess spacebar, and a few more letters as well. Okay, so here's the final one. So I guess this is if you don't know him, he's a very famous German leader. Who has done some very, very bad things, who was delusional, not in particular competent. He could speak well, but when it came to making actual decisions, he had, I guess, some success, but I guess a lot of other people were deciding for him. And whenever he himself had to make very difficult decisions, he would usually not do too well. A kind of idealistic person. So let's see. Okay, he is supposed to be a person of variety, adventure, freedom, challenge, playfulness, restlessness, and curiosity. Okay, and what about inner number? It appears to be the same. Okay, so I guess Mr. A, he was rather adventurous. I don't think he wanted freedom for others, but I guess he wanted to be free himself. Yep, he liked the challenge. I'm not sure whether he was playful, but I do know that he was trying to be an artist, so I guess that might be okay. Restlessness, okay, so fight does apply. Curiosity, not sure about that. Variety, not sure about that either. So far it appears to be maybe potentially correct, but I mean even broken clocks are right sometimes. So far it's only like 25% chance of being correct, and that's very poor chance of prediction. I mean, for example, police, detectives, I guess lawyers, they would find this a laughable, I guess, example, laughable evidence. And I myself find this kind of numerological calculator to be rather inaccurate, to say the least. But I still got a few more names. Okay, Ted Bundy. This is the next one. Ted, spacebar. Okay, Ted. I thought I put two spacebars, but I believe at least I saw it. I guess it's impossible to make more than one spacebar in a row. Okay, so Ted Bundy. Okay, here we go. This is not a full name, but let's see what we have to see. Practicality, orderliness, responsibility, planning, steadfastness, and work. I don't think it's a very I mean, it didn't, I guess, feel a responsibility for murdering people, but I guess he was planning, he was steadfast. I guess he did work, he did appear orderly. I guess he did go for practical methods. So maybe this numerological calculator might be recovering. Let's look at the inner numerology, and it looks like we are wrong yet again. Compassion, philanthropy, generosity, idealism, magnanimity, completion, culmination. So definitely compassion is not going to apply. Generosity probably not as well. So there we go. I guess I spoke too soon. So far we have 20% accuracy, and even that one correct case, it was kinda fishy. So I still got three more names, and these names appear to be going through very quickly because, I mean, this is a very bare bones interpretation. It does some mathematics, but the explanation is very simple because, I mean, we are only numbers from 0 to 9. Imagine that, from 0 to 9. Sure, the alternative number could be also from 0 to 9, so I guess let's multiply it together. Actually, from 1 to 9, my apologies. So from 1 to 9 it would be 9. So we are talking about 9 multiplied by 9, which would be 81 different readings. So 7 billion people in the world right now are living, and based on this, basically, if you would walk to your people, you would talk to them, if you do some research based on this numerology calculator, there would only be 81 different personalities available. So even the reading amount is rather low, and it's again another factor which does reduce accuracy. Also, I mean, a lot of people's behaviors are probably influenced by genetics, by, I guess, gender, and I guess by a place where they are born, and it is what affects how they come out as a person, like surroundings, what kind of family I was raised in. But the name, the actual name given, is given by a parent. It's not given, I guess, by the circumstances in which a person will live. And it doesn't matter if a person might be good, a worse person might be bad, but most of the people are not psychic, at least not sufficiently enough psychic. So the kinds of names being given are often random. A kinds of names which people will find most interesting, most pleasant to hear. Or maybe they look up some deeper meaning, which probably will not come in a form of numbers, it will rather come in a form of some other explanation, like spiritual meaning of name X. Okay, so that's some additional factors just completely discredit this name numerology thing. Okay, so I guess I will go with his full name. I don't think I did that. So, do I have this option? I do. Okay. Oh, wrong letter. Alright. Theodore. Okay, Theodore. Robert. Theodore, Robert. Where's the letter R? T? Spacebar and Bundy. Okay. Here we go. It was all typed down. So, what are we dealing with? I guess as a full name, it should be more, I guess, accurate. So, we're dealing with practicality, orderliness, responsibility, planning, steadfastness, and work. I believe this is the same thing. I guess. It does appear rather accurate, let's put it that way. I don't agree with the responsibility, but other than that, it might be something which might work out for this particular person, so I guess so far I will change it to something like, I guess, 30% accuracy. Something, I mean, I didn't do exact mathematics, so time to go to my next name. So this particular person, I guess I will go with his full name immediately. So let me think. Okay, so this is probably A and I, because I see letter L here. So I will be typing him now. Okay, a few more letters and we'll have a first name. Alright, now the middle name. Okay, and if you want, you can even make predictions what kind of person I'm typing down. Alright, letter I. So far so good. And the final name, probably it will give you a good clue who he is. So let me type it down, and we have a name which is Alphonse Gabriel Capone, or commonly known as Al Capone. Al Capone, I mean, my pronunciation is not perfect, but you get the idea. You probably know who this guy is, and if you don't know, you can make some research. Okay. So we are dealing with some contemplation, introversion, wisdom, mysticism, stoicism, spirituality, perfectionism. This guy, I don't think he was rather a spiritual person. I don't think he was into mysticism. Now, stoicism in particular. Let me make a quick check. I got an idea of what it means. But just to be sure. So, okay, I guess I'll go for word definition. Maybe this will do better. Okay. So far what I'm reading. So stoicism is a repression of emotion and indifference to pleasure and so on. So definitely not the Al Capone I know. What about the inner reading? Domesticity, companionship, love, nurturance, care, comfort, and service. Yet again, Mr. Al Capone was a criminal. He was a criminal during Prohibition, and a matter of fact that, I mean, alcohol was being prohibited. I think, yeah, it was illegal to have alcohol during those days, but it was a stupid law, so I guess it is understandable, but to my knowledge, this Al Capone person did some other crimes which are actually rather evil. So there we go, another name and another, I guess, failure. Okay, so I now have, I guess, my two final names, so I will try to go through them rather quickly. So first one is, I guess I will keep you guessing, but you probably might know already who this person is. So let me rush it up. Okay. Oh, I believe there should be an alternative writing way. Yep, here we go. Now, I guess the final name is Parker. Okay, letter P. Oh, I found the letter, so I guess I'm really getting skilled at this. Okay. So let's see. So practicality, orderliness, responsibility, planning, steadfastness, and work. I'm not in particular believing on this explanation. And this particular person, to my knowledge, was a criminal. She was working with another person. And they together did some crimes, were caught, and they were killed. I wouldn't call them, for that reason, orderliness. I don't believe they were practicality. Maybe it did apply to them, but I find it rather questionable. Now, responsibility, I really doubt that. I mean, at least in a sense of responsibility to society. Maybe she was responsible to her partner, but overall, again, questionable. Planning, I guess I will agree with that. Steadfastness, maybe. And work, I guess if you consider robbing banks work, I guess she was a working individual, but overall, let's say I guess I am overall fine with this explanation, but the fact that it was orderliness was mentioned, it makes me question this reading, but okay, I guess I will just give it a very weak pass. Okay, so let's go into our final name. This will be the final person because I don't see much need to go any further with this. Or maybe I just go with the name first. So, okay, where's the letter? You probably know who this person is, or maybe you have heard of him. And he is associated with this the previous person mentioned. So basically, this is, I guess, the man of Bonnie and Clyde duo. So Bonnie was a girl, a female, and Clyde was a man. Okay, so let me go with this. Okay, so if I stop and I start looking, I want to make sure that if any of these special cases of double letters apply, but I would type them correctly. Okay, just N letter, U letter, and the last word is barrel. All right, double R. Where are you? Here you are. All right. It's actually letter O. And here we go, final name. So, selfhood, individuality, creativity, beginning, leadership, young, ambition, power. Okay. It does appear that this does apply to this particular person, but let's not rush into conclusions. We still have got inner reading. So, they say it's practicality, orderliness, responsibility, planning, steadfastness, and work. So from all the readings up to this point, I do believe that this is the one of the most accurate. So I do up my standards if I would look at this reader professionally. Well, I start to speak about creativity in particular, beginning with you, but about all the others, I guess I can agree that, let's say, I did say that some of these previous names, name numerology was quite correct, but it was not fully correct. For this case, I believe this is the most correct case. So I say that from eight names I investigated, I had only one correct, truly correct guess. I mean, at this point, it's really guesswork. I mean, nothing special about it. So overall, as you can see, classical name numerology calculator does not work, and it's not good means for I mean to get any good results for your future, for who you are. You are who you are. I think you were living with yourself for many years already. I mean, if you can read it, if you can understand what I'm speaking, you're at least some years old. So basically, I mean, you know yourself. You don't need others to tell who you are. You just should be able to feel yourself. You should be able who you are. So basically, this is, I guess, a tool to inspire you, this numerology calculator. But what it's saying, it's not necessarily accurate. It's probably not. If it's accurate, it's because of luck. And you are who you decide to be. So basically, if you have a problem, I mean, this is not a place for you to look answers. If you're looking for solutions to your personal problems, or you want to find more about yourself, look for other means, because this is not going to help you. I guess a final check. I just figured out. Let's check my, I guess, BitChute channel name. Of course, number one is not available. Or maybe I will add that as a word. Okay, letter M. Okay, letter T and letter E. Okay, so domesticity, companionship, love, nurture, nurturance, care, comfort, and service. It does apply. But a lot of these things, they are about good people, basically. I mean, a lot of us, in some aspects, we are rather similar. Sure, we are very different personalities, but deep into our core, I guess we all want some love. We have friends for whom we care. And I mean, maybe all these readings, if you would read all of them, something would probably apply to all of us. Because look at all these words. One of these words is probably bound to apply to us in one way or another. So, for example, me, domesticity, not really. Companionship, kind of. Love, probably. Nurturance, yes. Care, yes. Comfort, yes. And service, definitely. So, a few words are incorrect. And some are correct. And as you can see, if this was a true reading, everything would be correct. All the words would be strong yes, but for one word in particular, I don't agree with. And if a few words I agree very really. And this is how it works. If you really want to look for a very good numerology system, if it exists, you should look for explanation which is dead on, because it was given your name at the start of your life, and that name is sticking with you for the remainder of your life, unless you really, for some legal reasons, you want to change it. And basically, your name will be affecting you for the remainder of your life. So if your name has got so much power, these words right here, they should be applying, and they should be 100% correct. So here we go. I guess inner reading. Union, cooperation, stability, following, continuity, union, receptivity, gentleness. Okay, I guess I do agree. But this outer, I guess the explanation did spoil the situation for me. I mean, credibility was already spoiled, destroyed by my previous test. So, okay. I guess maybe there might be some credibility, but at least for bad people or evil ones, there's no way to tell whether they are evil or they are not. And for good people, hey, I don't know who you are. You need to check yourself. I mean, I cannot go inside a person. I guess I could go for my family and so on. That's rather, I don't want to go make those names public. But, I mean, for people, you think a person is one thing, but deep inside they might feel otherwise. So just judge people over public images, again, not accurate. I guess for those evil people, it did apply because, I mean, actions speak louder than words. And they really had made some actions that really make it rather predictable what type of people they are. But overall, I mean, yet again, this is just very, very inaccurate. And I mean, I could just keep going and going, but this is just not a credible psychic system. And I'm definitely not returning to this one. Okay, so ultimate one. Variety, adventure, freedom, challenge, playfulness, restfulness, and curiosity. Hey, so this does apply for me too. So, we had one reading which kind of applied, and this reading which kind of applies. So, which one is it? Because if two readings apply, I mean, I'm only one kind of person, so if two readings apply, so it means that if I got just one reading, it means I'm only getting half a picture, and the other half of the picture is hidden, therefore it is inaccurate, and as a result, I might be misled. And probably the case is that, as I said, all these different readings, because there are just 9 different stories, and 81 different combination actually, but 9 different stories. So probably because it's just so condensed, because 7 or 8 billion people in the world, and I mean only 9 ways to describe them. Of course, probably a lot of this is going to apply to me. So as a result, I mean, no way we are going to be accurate. So as a result, I did my research, I did my investigation, and now as a conclusion for the very end, I can say it clearly with strong confidence that the name numerology test, at least on psychicscience.org, is completely fraudulent. I mean, and maybe it's a strong word, maybe it might work for some people, but I make, at least it's my opinion at this point, but I have a strong opinion that if this is accurate, it's because you got lucky. And maybe you should try different readings and see if different reading would apply to you as well, because 9 different types of readings. Check all those 9 readings and just see how many of them would apply to you personally. So this is my advice for you if you want to test out the system. And by the way, the link to the site will be in the description below. So check it out if you want to do the test yourself. But anyways, I mean, if you liked what you saw, you can leave a like. If you have something to comment, leave a comment. I should be notified about it. I don't make a strong promise, but I should. And I will be glad to read your comment. I would like to see what are your thoughts. If you have criticism, I will address it. And if you have something good to say, it's great. Probably I will reply as well. And I mean, I really make this with passion and love in my heart. I want to provide something useful to your world. And if your world is appreciating it, it's great. And if world has got some suggestions on how I might be able to improve my content, is great as well. So I'm great for all kinds of, I mean, I'm very welcome to all kinds of feedback. And if you subscribe, you should have easier time finding my material in the future, and I do intend to continue this psychic series for a long time to come. So anyways, thank you for watching, and I hope you had a beautiful, great day, and this video was helpful to you. Maybe it made you wiser, and maybe it just helped you to have a better day. So thank you for watching, and it's time to end the video.